Upon his arrival in 1961, it did not take long for Windsor native Jack Cowin to make his presence felt at Western. One of the province's top high school recruits, he immediately cracked the Mustang lineup as a two-way lineman. Standing 6'3 and weighing 205 pounds, he terrorized quarterbacks with his unrelenting pass rush. As a freshman, Jack led voting at the defensive tackle position for the Canadian Press All-Star Honors, and the Western Gazette awarded him as the school's overall best freshman athlete. Exhibiting incredible focus on the football field, Jack also dominated on the wrestling mat, and his two-sport athlete grappled for Western every year, eventually winning the Ontario Heavyweight Championship in his third and final year, 1963. While the football Mustangs were struggling in the win-loss column in 61 and 62, Cowin was still dominating in the trenches, recognized as a Canadian Press All-Star for a second consecutive season. He also helped running back Whit Tucker achieve the same status with his play on the O-line. The 1963 season saw the Mustangs back in contention, and Cowin obtained his third consecutive Canadian Press All-Star Award, as well as being the recipient of the George McCullough Trophy as the team's most outstanding player. Upon graduation, Jack was drafted by the Winnipeg Blue Bombers in the first round of the draft. That was in 1964. Leaving football behind, Cowin took another passion, as witnessed by former teammate John Nash, who remembers Jack, fresh out of high school, convincing the city of Windsor to take on the nickname the Rose City, and then turning around and selling them roses for a profit. Or getting up first thing in the morning and putting on his best farmer clothes to go out to the country and sell bushes to farmers. Working for London Life, Jack took the advice of his father and headed to the other side of the world. Starting with one Kentucky Fried Chicken outlet, he became one of Canada's most successful entrepreneurs in Australia. Now known as the father of fast food down under, he's the executive chairman of one of Australia's largest privately held businesses, which has expanded into such endeavors as meat processing, wineries, and television. As Jack Cowin said himself, the contact, the emotions, the drive you experience in sport are all elements that make up life. And Jack Cowin has never forgotten his roots at Western. Becoming one of the greatest benefactors, the football team alone has benefited from the generosity, as the alumni stands bear the name of his father, Stanley J. Cowin, a result of Jack's generous donation during the construction of TD Waterhouse Stadium. The Mustang players also benefit from Cowin's generosity every year, as one of its own is awarded an Australian work internship program and heads down to obtain some business experience under the tutelage of Jack Cowin. As John Metris used to say, Jack Cowin, our man in Australia. We say today, Jack Cowin, a Mustang legend.